Before we officially begin, it's only prudent to take a moment to thank a few people that without them, this wouldn't be possible. I want to say thank you to our counseling staff, Mrs. Geyer, Ms. Everhart, Mrs. Lavick, and Mrs. Schmidt. Also thank you to Ms. Epperson, Mr. Albers, Mrs. Robertson, Mr. Sentman. Thank you to Hobart Arena and the Career Center for the lovely venue. Thank you to Always Blooming Florist for the roses. Corey Graphics for this incredible banner, as well as the Senior Signs, Expressions Photography, and the Movement Church for providing the live stream. Students, parents, and families, staff, Superintendent Mr. Mark Stefanik, Assistant Superintendent Mr. Steve Verhoff, Assistant Principal Mrs. Amy Epperson, School Board President Ms. Teresa Dunaway, and School Board members Ms. Corinne Dahl, Ms. Ann Zakor, Mr. Simon Patrick, and anyone else that's joining us, good evening and welcome to Tippecanoe High School's 144th commencement ceremony. Tonight we add another chapter to the proud history of our school by celebrating the graduates of the class of 2021. Graduates, you have persevered through a time like no other, and everyone gathered here tonight, and those watching the live stream, and quite frankly, the entire community, are so incredibly proud of you and your accomplishments. I am honored to share the next couple hours with you, and let's enjoy this celebration together. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce Superintendent of Tipp City Schools, Mr. Mark Stefanik.
Good evening. Graduates, go ahead and take a seat. Once again, good evening. On behalf of our entire school district, our community, and the Board of Education, welcome to the 2021 commencement ceremony. Before I get started, I'd like to introduce representing the Board of Education this evening. We have Ms. Corinne Dahl and Ms. Joellen Heatherly. So please welcome them to graduation today. To the graduates, congratulations. You stayed focused, you focused on your goals, and you succeeded through a very challenging time. Over a year, but you made it. Before I get started with my comments, I'd like to take a moment to share a few comments from Board President Ms. Dunaway, who was unable to attend this evening's ceremony. She sends her congratulations to the class of 2021 for your many successful endeavors, especially during this unique and challenging year. You made the best of the situations and triumphed because of your grit, tenacity, and optimism. As Dr. Seuss said, always remember, you are braver than you believe you are, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and twice as beautiful as you've ever imagined. Thank you, Ms. Dunaway, for those well wishes. Graduates, tonight is a celebration of learning, hard work, and achievement. A celebration of you, and you are so deserving of this celebration. Your graduation is the ultimate reward for what you have accomplished during your 13 years in school. Amongst you are our soon-to-be graduates. We have outstanding scholars. We have skilled athletes. We have passionate volunteers. Your creative writers, performers, artists, talented musicians, and vocalists. You embody Tipp City School's tradition of excellence. When you think back on your education, tonight and in the future, go all the way back to that first day in kindergarten. Work your way through the years, through your last day in classes this year, and consider what impacted you the most. What do you remember about your first day in kindergarten or that kindergarten year? And during these 13 years, who was or who is your favorite teacher? What characteristics does this person have that made him or her so special to you? What class influenced you the most? Did it impact your career choice or your future direction? And while you reflect, pause for a moment to appreciate the people in your life and the impact they made on you. As you move forward, always consider what you can do to leave a mark on someone else. And here we are. Now, as you reflect on the last 15 to 16 months, your mind might gravitate towards what wasn't, what you missed, what you lost because of the pandemic. In fact, I caught a glimpse of your senior t-shirt and you summed it up in a humorous way. Our 2.5 years of high school sure went by fast. You might think you got shortchanged, and to some degree, you did. Many activities were canceled, including this year's homecoming and last year's prom. But I hope in addition to your quality education, you leave here with self-confidence, strong friendships, and unforgettable memories. Remember, too, what you gained in the face of adversity and challenges. You developed resiliency, adaptability, strength, and patience. You matured and you nurtured essential life skills. Tonight, you are celebrating a milestone that signals an end and a beginning. Let the end be the start of a beautiful beginning. Go and do great things. Go and make a difference. Congratulations.
We live in the greatest country in the world with freedoms like no other. We not only want to honor those who have made the ultimate sacrifice defending our country, but also those who are currently serving or have committed to serve our nation. Thank you, all of you, for your service. With us today, we have all of our students who have made this commitment, and I'd like to invite them all to come to the stage and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Everyone, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you.
First to address the class of 2021 is World Language Club President and Student Senate Representative London Eberly.
We spend 15% of our entire lives in school. 15% of all of our life experiences will have occurred in the classrooms of your favorite teachers, in the lunchroom with your favorite foods, or lack thereof, and with friends whom you would have never known otherwise. A 15% where we open our lockers to the same empty water bottle and return to our assigned seat that we learned to call our own. Within this 15%, we have grown up preparing to miss what was right in front of us. I'm sure we have all heard the cliche caveat that it all goes by so fast. But hasn't it? We began at only age 5, pushing through AR reading tests and book fairs where we spent the coveted $10 our parents gave us on chocolate calculators and bendy pencils we would lose by the end of the day. We played kickball and foursquare and choreographed dances to Taylor Swift and Katy Perry for the halftime show during recess football games. Our biggest worries were whether we had ordered a pretzel for pretzel day or if we did well enough on the times tables test to earn the ice cream sundae bar. Middle school began with a poignant sense of a new insecurity, but ended with a confidence that soon we would be high schoolers. Within a mix of unfamiliarity and excitement, we found an unconventional safety in Mr. Tui's hallway music or Mr. Zing's joke of the day. Shout out to Mr. Kanapke because he did it first. And we can't forget the cadence of Mr. Tipton's "How now, brown cow," that we may be blessed to hear every so often. Beyond the hours of 7:40 to 2:40, we were reminded of what makes high school worthwhile. Football games where we put on face paint and cheer until our voices hurt, and pep rallies where we watch each other frantically win scooter races and musical chairs. Homecoming dances and proms where we trip on each other's dresses, and powder puff games where the homecoming acrylic nails get broken. High school is a perpetual image of nostalgia, the place our parents reminisce about and experiences we will be sure to tell our children of. Although it may not feel like it, it is a time of our life where we are at the peak of our physical capabilities while having the lowest responsibility or expectation. Under a mountain of complaints and groans at homework assignments and painful stretches to morning alarms, there is a gratitude we reluctantly share for all the good that has come within these past 12 years. We have not only learned how to read and multiply, but how to share and make friends, how to trust and how to empathize, and most importantly, how to grow. A 15% that has taught us the value of all that lies beyond that small number. What begins now is a special kind of discomfort that comes from an unknown unfamiliarity of the 85%, a percentage of opportunity in new. And what lies ahead of all of us is choice, independence, and possibility, and a particular sense of a new beginning. Our kindergarten dreams of becoming actresses or astronauts may have shifted ever so slightly, but your 6-year-old self would be amazed at where you are today, and even more excited about where you are going. Though this is an accomplishment, it is more a celebration of a valuable transition. A celebration of moving beyond what we know now to a period of discovery and an exploration of ourselves beyond the expectations of high school. Be proud of what you have accomplished and bring passion to the places you go. To the class of 2021, congratulations, and here is to the next 85%.
Next up, we have Adam Reed and Gavin Martin singing the song Edelweiss by Richard Rodgers, and they would like to dedicate the song to their mothers.
Next, addressing the class of 2021 is Student Senate Representative and Vice President of Symphonic Choir, Jayla Fletcher.
God, I feel like I'm gonna pass out. Okay. This past year has definitely been a year. I mean, having to adjust every single aspect of our lives because of a global pandemic is definitely not what any of us were expecting. But look at us, we made it, and I know that's super cheesy and cliche to say, but we did. Whether it was just another year of work, or to another year of school, or in our case, to graduation. Wow, 12 whole years of school together. Honestly, I thought it wasn't gonna end, and I'm not really sure I wanted it to. I always knew it would come at some point, but if you look around, we have all been a part of each other's lives for so long that we are who we are today because of each other. We've made best friends, enemies or frenemies, whatever you want to call them, that won't matter within the next week, and so many memories that will last us a lifetime. To start off, I wanted to help us remember some funny moments we all got to witness together. Like when there was a student-teacher basketball game and Mr. Oakes, our old vice principal, did something to his ankle and was riding around the school on a little knee scooter. We also can't forget about the time the seniors, for their senior prank, sprayed fart spray in our freshman hallway, and it smelled really, really bad. And lastly, my personal favorite is when a student somehow lost a chicken in this school, and I'm really upset that I don't know what events could have possibly led up to that. But we've all had our own unique and different experiences throughout the years, and to be honest with you guys, being who I am did make it a little bit nerve-wracking for me to come to school. Obviously, I don't look like majority of people in this room, which can be intimidating and very scary, but there are so many people in this room who have taught me to know that that's okay. And chances are the same exact thing will happen to every single one of us at some point in our lives, where sometimes you just don't feel like you're the same as everyone else, and mine just happened to be in high school. But within all those feelings and nerves, you'll find it in the end, we're all the same. No matter what we look like, who we're friends with, or what our passions are, we're all just trying to live life in the best way that we possibly can. As we all know, high school wasn't always sunshine and rainbows. We all had some types of issues with at least one person. Maybe it was a teacher, a coach, a fellow student, or even ourselves. But that's just how life is, and that's how it always will be. And high school was just the first place to teach us that lesson, along with many other lessons that we will use in our life. And I can only say thank you to everyone who helped me learn them. Thank you to the people who I didn't necessarily get along with for teaching me how to act in a situation that didn't go my way. Thank you to the people who showed me how to have a good time in Tipp City when God knows there's nothing to do around here. Thank you to the teams I was a part of that showed me the meaning of teamwork. Thank you to the coaches that taught me to keep going, even though I wanted to stop. Thank you to the teachers who were patient with me, even though I did sleep in your class. Thank you to the group chats that were made for each class to let me know when the homework was due, which I most likely didn't finish. And thank you to my best friend, Emily, for showing me the true value of friendship. And lastly, a huge thank you to my family for always having my back and for all the unconditional love you give me, even when we butt heads. And I also want to throw out a thank you to Quizlet, because I feel like that's for everyone. I'm going to miss the sporting events, the choir concerts, Mr. Zing's jokes of the day, the incredible school lunches, especially the cheesy bread and the ravioli, and definitely all of you. Even though this might be the last time some of us are going to be in the same room together, just know that when I tell my future kids the crazy and over-exaggerated stories of high school, I'll remember how much I loved these times and the huge impact you all had on me and how much I miss it. My mom, who is also my biggest supporter, would always tell me the saying, good, better, best, never let it rest until your good is better and your better is best. That quote is constantly running through my mind because it can relate to almost anything and everything you do. School, work, relationships, anything. So when you leave this arena today as a Red Devil alumni and you start the next chapter of your life, always try to make your good, your better, your best, and make a promise to yourself that you will never let it rest. Thank you, and congratulations, everyone.
Next, performing You'll Never Walk Alone is choir member and THS Theater Program alumni, Riley Trezak.
Dream.
Next, giving a speech to the class of 2021 is Student Senate Representative and Astro Club Vice President Cameron Earle.
Hey, everyone. One night this past April, I sat in my kitchen for a long time trying to think of a good opener for this speech, trying to think of something inspirational or catchy, something that would grab everyone's attention and make me come off as a great writer. But the more I sat and realized that if I was going to write a graduation speech for my peers, I wanted it to be a heart-to-heart with my classmates, and not a perfect speech I'd receive an A on in language arts class. A lot of you probably don't know me to be the sentimental type. I'm usually not the type to open up. However, today is a very special occasion, and I thought it would be a good time to. So this is me talking to you all, heart to heart. Over the past 12 years of school together, a lot has happened. Many of us here met each other when we were 6 or 7 years old, which is hard to believe. We started out with our primary concerns in life being what was contained in our lunch boxes and whether or not there was an open seat on the swings during recess. We chased each other around on the playground, counted candy in class, learned how to pronounce letters, and so on and so forth. Before we knew it, we were out of elementary school and into the fourth grade. Our two elementary schools came together, and then miraculously, we went to school with twice as many people. We started to worry about more important things, like what games we would be playing on the computers and what fractions were. We found out what algebra was, and to say the least, we didn't like it. We started to develop friend groups and more complex personalities, and before we knew it, we were in middle school. Once we hit middle school, things began to change. We started to worry about grades and popularity and who was going to be our first kiss. We noticed our bodies changing all of a sudden, and our parents seemed to be quite an embarrassment at the time. I think I can confidently speak on behalf of all of you in here, saying that we're glad that stage is over. 3 years of middle school went by in a flash, and then bam, we were in high school, the last stage. We still worried about what was for lunch, or at least I know I did, but there was a lot more to worry about than just that. We had to start worrying about the grades that would go in our transcripts. We encountered things like anxiety and depression. We had to start worrying about getting jobs and filling out resumes. A lot of us began to leave behind the friends we had grown up with and started to branch out. We started to go to football games, dances, college visits, parties, and much more. But through it all, through all the late nights, good days, bad days, car rides, lunches, boyfriends and girlfriends, we are all in this room right here, right now. You all should be proud of that. Now I will share with you some of the lessons high school taught me. There's plenty, but I'll just share with you the ones that I've found to be most important. To be honest with you guys, when I came into high school, I was a different person than I am now. I would treat anyone that didn't go along with my opinions or beliefs horribly. I wouldn't let things go, and I would treat many as if I were better than them. Two people played a big part in helping me change that, even if they might not know it. They showed me that everyone is different, and having different people in our lives with different beliefs, strengths, and personalities makes us stronger. They showed me that working well with people is the key to success. They showed me that sometimes you have to let things go. And finally, they showed me that doing your best to be on good terms with every person you come across will only ever do you good. Andrew Doviak and Nick Shirley, I thank you both for showing me those things. There are a few other things that high school taught me. It taught me that people don't always treat you the way you treat them. Sometimes people don't reciprocate your energy. Sometimes you give more than you get back. Sometimes not all hard work pays off, but that's no reason to give up on life and humanity, because there will always be someone that reciprocates that energy back, and there will always be a time when that hard work pays off. And that's what keeps me going. Finally, high school taught me life begins where your comfort zone ends. If you never step out of your comfort zone and never take the risks of failure, you will never grow. And that goes for everything in life. Now finally, my hopes for myself and for you all in the future ahead of us. I hope you all show thanks to those that get you where you're going. I hope you all dance when the opportunity arises and that you don't work too much. I hope you all make the time for those you love and care about even if it means sacrificing your time or your money. I hope you all never give up on humanity, regardless of those that do you wrong. I hope you all try new foods at restaurants, even if sometimes the food ends up tasting a lot worse than what you thought it would. I hope you all spend your money on experiences and memories and not on things that can be bought. I hope you all let go of things like how many followers you have and whether or not you're one of the popular kids. And lastly, I hope you all find ways to give back to all the things that got you to where you are. I hope I do all these things. I hope I can make a positive impact in the worlds of those around me. I hope I can do something that matters. I hope I don't let money change me. I hope I'm the guy nobody is afraid to come to. And more than anything, I hope we all love endlessly and never give up on our pursuit of happiness. I'd like to thank my mom and my dad for showing me the value of hard work, and I would like to thank you all for the impacts you have made in my life, big or small. Congratulations and good luck.
Next, singing Breakaway by Kelly Clarkson is choir member Libby Cabus and band member Braden Stewart.
Take a chance, make a change, and break away.
Next, to address the class of 2021 is CTC Fire EMS graduate, Haley Ford.
Why does your heart start pumping on this stage? So we made it past COVID. COVID sucked. And we made it through the struggles of online school. Today, we get our diplomas and we start a new chapter. And as scary as that seems, it's something that we need to do to move on. So the only thing that can get us to the goals that we want to reach is dedication. And that's what I'd like to talk to you guys about today. According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, dedication is defined as the quality of being dedicated or committed to a task or purpose. We all have dedication right now. It was to sports or CCP classes or even your clubs, but now we're all graduating and all our dedication is going to move to something different. To graduate high school, we had to push past everything that made us nervous, everything, all those tests and quizzes and band performances and choir performances. But now we're graduated, or almost, and so now we have to move past. Every single job that what each of us wants to do after we graduate is valid. We all need to do our jobs to make our communities run smoothly. Whether you want to be a nurse or a doctor, first responder, construction worker, architect, you name it, we need it. And our community would not be able to run without them. As we grow into adults, we should be using our dedication to push toward our dream careers. We are kids once. High school is over. And now we need to push past that fear and go toward what is best for us. We should be striving for nothing less than the best. With that, let me introduce you to the most cliche dedication quote out there. With hard work and dedication, anything is possible. It's so easy to want to give up when we fail. I know this personally. It's scary. Stop taking failure as an excuse to give up, but rather as a reason to push harder. When I was going to CTC for Fire Academy, it was almost terrifying, to say the least. Our fire instructors pushed us to our mental and physical limits every single day. We worked out, did tasks that seemed almost crazy, and sometimes threw up in the parking lot, but you know, that's not too important. When I was starting my senior year, I was scared. I was scared of the future, and I was scared of all of the tasks that we would have to do our senior year. I let anxiety stop me from overcoming the tasks that I needed to do, but it took me listening to my teachers, my classmates, my parents, and my friends to push past that fear. Again, sometimes I wanted to give up so badly, but I had to push past that to remember the end goal. Another time dedication pushed me forward was when I was taking EMT through Sinclair. I took EMT at night class, you know, it kind of sucked. It's honestly the best and worst decision I've ever made, and it was really stressful trying to get two certifications, work a job, do high school, you know, extracurriculars. It kind of added up. When it came time to take my class final, I went in there thinking, oh yeah, I got it, and then I failed my class final, and that hurt. I was so devastated, and I tore down every ounce of hope that I had. And it was until my instructor told me, oh yeah, you get a second attempt. And I was like, wait, what? I get a second attempt? And so that's when I knew I had to push a little harder. That second attempt was hard. They told me I would take it in 2 days at 8 a.m. on a Wednesday. And I had school the next day, so I really didn't have a whole lot of time to study. I used every second that I had to study, skipping time to spend with my friends, my family, and just push toward that end goal. I crammed and crammed and crammed for the stupid exam, and sure enough, when it came time to take it again, I passed. And that was the most exceptional feeling I've ever felt in my entire life. Now, I pushed myself through anxiety to get to that point, but you know, it's not all about me. It's about you guys, because we're all graduating. So when times get rough, we should not tear down all the hope we have. We should use that failure or use that anxiety to push us forward. Every single time something goes wrong, we shouldn't bow our heads and tear ourselves down, but rather we should lift ourselves higher. Class of 2021, we are the next generations to run our community. We are the next nurses, first responders, military, teachers, construction workers, you name it. And we are the next in line to push our world forward. Use your determination to move past this and become the best that you can be. Fuel your passion like a fire. Use your determination to get your dream career. You are worthy, and you are able to do anything you'd want to do. All you need is a little determination. Thank you.
The final performance of the evening will be Home by Philip Phillips, sung to you by our senior choir members.
Thank you. The last address to the class of 2021 is Student Senate President, NHS Treasurer, and my lifelong best friend, Amelia Zweizer.
Receive their high school diploma this evening. Hannah Marie Hobgood. Amelia May Zweizig, magna cum laude with honors in an associate degree of science. London Grace Eberly, magna cum laude with honors. Nicholas Robert Shirley, cum laude. Gavin Eric Martin. Adam Joseph Reed, cum laude. Catherine Lucille Owen, magna cum laude with honors. Jayla Renita Fletcher. Riley Catherine Trezak, magna cum laude. Cameron Robert Earl, cum laude. Elizabeth Rose Cabus, magna cum laude with honors. Lauren Alicia Williams, magna cum laude with honors. Braden Dwayne Stewart, magna cum laude with honors. Haley Grace Ford, cum laude with honors. Molly Marie Octoberg, cum laude with honors. Jordan Isaiah Atkins. Jenna Grace Alexander. Heidi Rosaline Allen, magna cum laude with honors. Griffin Paul Anderson. Megan Allison Ashburn, cum laude. Michael John Bach. Andrew Neil Bayless. Jonathan Allen Bayless. Jack Justin Baldwin, cum laude. Jared Allen Billington. Michael Keith Bittinger. Michael Anthony Blevins. Mason Thomas Boniface. John Jacob James Borton. Jack Emerson Brown. Trenton Kevin Brown. Chloe Charmaine Bynum. Tyler Levi Carlson. Kai Douglas Carmack. Morgan Elaine Chaplin. Owen Michael Clark. Jack Thomas Kleckner, cum laude. Zachary Taylor Klaus. Sydney Elizabeth Klein, magna cum laude with honors. Andrew Jacob Cook. Emily K. Cuvion, magna cum laude with honors. Alexis Renee Cullen. Gabriel Forrest Dollinghouse, cum laude with honors. Gavin James Darner, cum laude. Zachary Logan Davis, cum laude, with honors. Gabriel David Dean, magna cum laude, with honors. Dariana Paola Delgado. Chad Charles Detweiler. Danny McKenzie Detweiler, cum laude. Mackenzie Marie Dix. Savannah Lee Dodd, magna cum laude with honors. Brandon Charles Dolly. Olivia Claire Doviak.
You can go up there. It's okay.
Colton Allen Griffith. Haley Marie Downing. Liam James Durkin. Nicole Ann Earl, cum laude. Gabrielle Christine Ida Miller, magna cum laude with honors. Devin Lee Elwood. Alexis Michelle Evans. Tyler Janison Ferris.
Shelby Jameson Ferguson. Mackenzie Lou Foster, cum laude. Emma Elizabeth Fowler. Zachary Lynn Frederick, magna cum laude with honors. Kira Ashlyn Fry, cum laude. Nathan David Gagnon, magna cum laude with honors. McKaylee Lane Grimmett. Zachary Mitchell Gudorf. Peter James Guevara, magna cum laude, with honors. Caitlin Grace Gustafson, cum laude, with honors. Morgan Ann Haas, cum laude, with honors. Owen Lawrence Haddon. Anastasia Elizabeth Kathleen Hamish. James Nathaniel Richard Harden. Blake Judson Healy. Aiden Michael Hefner. Paige Elise Heitkamp, magna cum laude, with honors and an Associates of Arts. Caitlin Sue Hemmelgarn, magna cum laude, with honors. Matthew Lewis Henn. Micaiah Thomas Herring. Emma Joelle Hughes. Jade Elizabeth Hotz. Lauren Elizabeth Holderman, magna cum laude, with honors. Bailey Giel Hoover, cum laude, with honors. Isaiah Michael Hoover. Noah Alexander Horn, cum laude. Taylor Renee Horn. Caitlin Elizabeth Husick, cum laude, with honors. Phoebe Luella Jacobs, magna cum laude. Hunter Anthony Jesse. Dylan James Johnson. Jaina Elaine Johnson, cum laude. Allison Marie Johnston. Jada Lee Keaton. Jaden Elizabeth Kendall, cum laude, with honors. Kayla Michelle Kendall, cum laude. Brianna Lynn Kidwell. Simone Gabrielle King, cum laude. Abigail Marie Kinsey. Brady Allen Kinsman, cum laude, with honors. Benjamin Douglas Knosman, cum laude, with honors. Joshua Logan Kosovar. McKenna K. Kugler, magna cum laude, with honors. Logan Michael Kreinbrink. Sydney Irene Lang, cum laude. Emma Renee Lara, cum laude. Elena Nicole Liskey, magna cum laude, with honors. Levi Taylor Lucas. Ashley Ann Mader, magna cum laude, with honors. Zoe Marlowe Maggard. Audrey Lauren Mahaney. Bryce Allen Martin. Samuel Russell Martineau. Patrick Eugene McCaffrey, magna cum laude, with honors. Jack Ryan McMacken, cum laude, with honors. Alicia Lauren Miller, magna cum laude, with honors. Emma Marie Miller. Marissa Jem Miller. Noah Harrison Miniman. Adam David Nelson. Madeline Rose Nelson. Christopher Robert Nichols, magna cum laude, with honors.
Pierce Patrick Patterson. Ethan Clement Perrault. Anthony James Peters, magna cum laude with honors. Jacob Charles Phyllis. Joseph Matthew Plyman, magna cum laude with honors. Louis James Plose. Aiden Elliott Poland. Nicholas Austin Price. Anne Marie Reif with honors. Promise Marie Ramsey. Braden David Rigglesberger. Devin George Repogel. Emily Nicole Rhodes, cum laude with honors. Hannah Elizabeth Rittenhouse, cum laude with honors. Mason J. Robbins, cum laude with honors. Nicholas John Robbins, cum laude. Elizabeth Christine Rogers. John Logan Rogers. Jaden Michael Runyon. Alyssa Nicole Sasser with honors. Dakota Lee Schroeder, cum laude. Avery Brooke Shevlin, magna cum laude with honors. Seth Harrison Chuchat, magna cum laude with honors. Corinne Marie Singfrey, magna cum laude with honors. Jacob Edward Smith. Jacob Lee Smith, magna cum laude with honors. Kenna Renee Smith, magna cum laude with honors. Lacey Ann Snyder, cum laude. Jason Daniel Spears. Blake Aaron Swab. Braden Daniel Swank, magna cum laude with honors. Camden Gary Swartout. Caleb Abibi Tedesi. Isaac Abibi Tedesi. Ashlyn Jean Tarzinski, cum laude. Troy Andrew Taylor. Samantha Ellen Tiemann, magna cum laude with honors. Kevin Leo Thompson, magna cum laude with honors. Elena Jeanette Titley, magna cum laude. Owen Avery Trimble. Kaylee Sue Turner, magna cum laude with honors. Sydney Elizabeth Unger. Allison Grace Uzzell, magna cum laude with honors. Clayton Ronald Vaughn, magna cum laude with honors. Hannah Desiree Walkley, magna cum laude with honors. Emma Lynn Watkins. Savannah Lee Wade, cum laude. Rachel Lynn Wildermuth, magna cum laude with honors. Isabella Heaven Cherie Williams, cum laude. Oh. McKenna Renee Williams, cum laude. Peyton Julian Willis. Lucas Todd Wilson. Aspen D. Withrow. Zachary John Wood.
All right, let's do this. Man, look at all of you. Forgive me, but I need to take a second and take this all in. I shouldn't have started that way. Okay. Red Devils, I'm so incredibly proud of each and every one of you. All that stands between you and officially graduating is that you have to sit through my speech. But given that this is my last time to talk to you as a group, I suggest you get comfortable. It's going to be a minute. Red Devils, tonight is your night, and as I reflect upon the year we have had and the joy of listening to your classmates speak and perform, I can't help but be overcome with a sense of pride. Pride in what your classmates have shared and pride in what you have all accomplished in your time together. We've heard about the personal growth people have experienced, the value of celebrating not only what we share, but also our individual characteristics. We've heard about the value of hard work and perseverance, the value of experiences you've shared, and the excitement and potential you have for the future. Research would suggest that our brains are wired for negative bias, but you as a group have shown that that does not need to be the case. Sure, we all take some time to complain or express frustration, stupid COVID, but you faced a life-altering experience head-on and came out on top. Let's take a moment to highlight some of the amazing things that you've achieved together this past year. We've had one student named a National Merit Scholarship finalist. To achieve this honor, your PSAT score must be in the top 1% of the nation. Our marching band qualified for state. Actually, this class is qualified every time it was offered in their tenure. But there are several students that were accepted in honor bands, as well as performed in solo and ensemble events and winter drumline. We inducted 8 new members into our chapter of National Art Honor Society, and we also had 3 members receive honor courts, bringing our total membership to 18 members. We inducted 50 new members into our chapter of National Honor Society, bringing our current membership to 91. In athletics, we had 10 teams win MVL championships, 3 teams win district championships, 3 teams finish as district runner-up, 4 teams qualify for regional, and 2 of them win a regional championship. We had 1 team advance to the 3rd round of the OHSAA playoffs, and we qualified 1 team to state, finishing as the state runner-up. We had several athletes qualify to compete at the district, regional, and state level. We had 6 athletes named MVL Player of the Year, and many individuals earned additional accolades. Tippecanoe High School was recognized as the top high school by U.S. News and World Report Best High Schools list. And we also were recognized by GreatSchools.org for the 3rd year in a row, earning a college scholarship award. College Success Award, my bad. Additionally, it was a segue. Additionally, our graduating class has accepted an incredible amount of scholarships. This class, the class of 2021, in total was awarded over $3.35 million in scholarships. You always hear me say hashtag empower, but I'm not sure if I've ever told you why. The word empower is not just a word to me. It is how I approach life, here we go, and it's really grounded in my belief that everyone has the capacity to lead if given the opportunity. As educators, coaches, and families, it is our responsibility to provide you with the opportunities to feel safe, confident, strong, and, well, empowered. But as I reflect upon the year and all you've accomplished, Red Devils, you've not just taken the opportunities that you were given, you've empowered each other as teammates, classmates, friends, and family to exceed every expectation that we had for you. Hashtag together was the word for this year, and this was due in part to the pandemic, but truly, it was because rarely, if ever, any major challenge is overcome alone. So hashtag together is where true strength comes from. Class of 2021, you embody both of these concepts, and this, coupled with your determination, strength, and spirit, are what makes Tippecanoe High School and Tipp City so special. As you leave here as graduates of Tippecanoe High School, you are ready to redefine our world for the better. I know this because you've demonstrated the strength, perseverance, courage, and creativity necessary to do so. And based on what you've already accomplished, I know you will continue to exceed any and all expectations. But before you begin this journey, I'd be remiss if I didn't take this opportunity to provide you with some advice for your future. First, I know many of you will be getting apartments, and it's important to consider that if you buy a bigger bed, you will get more bedroom, but less bedroom. You knew you weren't getting out of here without one of those babies. All right. Let's go. All right, to be real, and you've probably heard me say this before, but I encourage you to define your why, your purpose, and align everything you do to this, because your actions will in turn influence others. Consider how you can lift others up and continue to empower them to reach their potential. In the end, the lives you touch and the impact you have will determine the story that will be told about you. Do not leave this up to chance. Live the story you want to be told, and leave no doubt in the eyes of others exactly who you are. I will caution you that this will not always be easy. Holding true to who you are can lead to adversity, but adversity makes you stronger. Holding true to who you are can lead to failure. But what is failure? Failure just means things didn't go according to plan. You've already shown that you have the tools necessary to adjust and adapt, so do not fear failure, for failure is just another opportunity to grow. Finally, as the leaders of our future, I ask you to consider that perhaps leadership is less about actually leading and more about providing others the tools to lead. Many of you have heard me use the quote by Simon Sinek before, but to me it perfectly sums up the overall message I have for you, so I'll say it again. Leadership is not about being in charge. Leadership is about taking care of people in your charge. Class of 2021, I want to thank you for making the time. My time is your principal. I was doing so well. An absolutely awesome experience that I will cherish forever. It's been an honor and a privilege to work with you, learn from you, and share in your successes and experiences. Words cannot express how incredibly proud I am of each and every one of you. And I cannot wait to see how much more you will accomplish in the future. From the bottom of my heart, congratulations, class of 2021. Much love, much respect. And for the last time, be the reason someone smiles today. Hashtag empower, hashtag together, go Red Devils.
Okay, she used to say class, that part.
Okay.
Oh,
Now we will begin to play the 2021 class song, I Lived by One Republic.
Class of 2021, please rise.
Don't feel the fall.
Now join us in moving our tassels. Congratulations, we graduated!
I lived.